One, books closed, crack me. Justin closes book, Byron's crack me. Hey, I hope you had a wonderful, restful weekend. Gosh, I thought it was very interesting, Jonathan, the question that was posed downstairs in town hall, because it made me think about major exams. The question, if you've forgotten already, was like, are schools, would schools be better off with or without major exams? The more I thought about it, Jeremiah, the more I think, my assertion is this, Byron. Maybe we're thinking about that question in the wrong way. See, I would argue, Jonathan, that major exams in life don't involve pencil and paper. I think the major exams in life are those exams that test your character, your integrity, who you are when no one is watching. Or maybe to put it in context, who you are when you know that there's no attention the next day. And I think for the majority of this team, I'm incredibly proud of the tests that you passed last week. How you continue to work hard regardless of the distractions in the room. Those are some major exams that at your age, you are passing with flying colors. And as we continue on with this final unit before we get into some review in preparation still for our state championship. I'm excited because at least 10 of you have earned merits for that strong, focused start this morning through town hall. So, get your snapping crews ready when you hear your teammates' names. Merits for sustained focus. Justin, Mia, Byron, Aiden, Joshua, Jonathan, Cesar, Zahara, Janice, Caitlin, Imani, Christian, Javier. Thank you so much for that strong start. I look forward to see how focused you will be during this. Think about it. In a moment, I'll turn off the light so you can see it a little clearer. First direction, name at the top, and then I'm going to give you some framing to help you remember what to do with volume today. 20 seconds to get classwork to teammates. Line bosses, go. Thank you. Remember, you already know this. Volume is equal to length times width times height. You already know that in a multiplication problem or a division problem, there's a total amount of each times root equals your total. Those are things you know. Also know how to read a three-dimensional figure. Remind me, from Friday, who's got that vocab? What type of shape is this? Do you remember with the person sitting next to you, see if you can remind them 20 seconds ago? Five, three, two, one. Super strong start, that's why I said his name earlier. Turn track, Jonathan. Jonathan, you can turn around and make him project.
Oh, when me and my partner said
it was a rectangular prism. Indeed, and you can label it rectangular prism. And Kevin, I noticed you also have labels on your page already. What did you label? Lessons.
I had
height,
and I had two inches.
So this point, you can have those four annotations on your page. If you're done with part A early, there's actually a part B on the next side that I challenge you to see if you can start. 5 minutes on the clock. I'm looking for how you're going to set up your work and make sense of this problem. Ready? Steady. Go.